Amen. We thank God again today for the privilege, first of all, of his allowing us to see this another day, and for having blessed us as he has during this day. In fact, we thank God for all of his blessings. Every day is a day of thanksgiving, and we give thanks, praise, honor, and glory to the God who is our refuge and our strength. And now, for today, there is again a word from the Lord. And here to bring us the word today is our own daughter of this church, our own associate minister, Minister Lettie Goodson. It is Youth Day, but she will be preaching not only to the youth, but I'm sure she will have a word for those of us who are not so young anymore. Because in God's word, there is something for the young, the not so young, and the old. So I want to thank God for sending us Minister Goodson today, and we know that she has a word to share with us, a word that God has given her to share with us. And may we be blessed by the word, and may our hearts be convicted for Jesus Christ, our Lord. So after the next selection, I present to you our own minister, Lettie Goodson, to share with us God's word.
If you're glad to be here in the house of the Lord, just one more time, just give him a wave offering.
Thank you, Lord, for one more time. One more time. One more time. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I give an honor to Jesus, and I give an honor to my pastor, and I just thank God for the opportunity. Thank God that he has bestowed upon me to stand behind this sacred podium to give his word today, and I thank God. I just thank God. First, I want to have prayer. Precious, wise, and almighty God, Lord, we thank you, God, for the opportunity, God. Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for this day. Lord, we just thank you, Lord. Lord, allow someone, Lord, to see you, Lord. Lord, I'm just asking you, Lord, to hide me, God. Hide me under your wing, Jesus. Lord, hide me, God. Let them see you and not me, because it's about you, God, and not about me. Lord, this is my prayer. Lord, these things I ask in your son Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Amen. And my title today is Jonah Made a Vow to the Lord. And my question to you today is, have you made a vow to the Lord? And there are some key words that I would like for you to keep in mind as I have my scriptures and I'm going forth and teaching the word. Some key words are a vow, grace, mercy, and second chance. That's a vow, grace, mercy, and second chance. My scriptures today are coming from Jonah 1, 4, and 17, Jonah 2 and 10, Jonah 3, 1 through 10, and Jonah's 4, 1, 2, 6, and 7. Praise God. Jonah was an Israelite who God had called to be a prophet, but who refused to accept his divine mission and left on a sea voyage instead. God then raised a great storm as a sign of his anger with Jonah. The sailors, realizing that Jonah's disobedience had caused the storm, they threw Jonah overboard in an attempt to save their ship. Praise God. Praise God. A person cannot run from God's plan. Praise God. Jonah 2 and 10, Jonah's prayer to God. Jonah is saved by God by being swallowed by a large fish in whose belly he spends 3 days and 3 nights. While in the fish, Jonah prays to God in his affliction and commits to thanksgiving and to paying what he vowed. There's that word, vowed. God then commands the fish to vomit Jonah out. Jonah's 3, 1 and 10. Jonah fulfills his mission and God's message to the world. On the first day Jonah started into the city, he proclaimed 40 more days and Nineveh would be overturned and destroyed. The Ninevites believed God and they declared a fast from the greatest to the least, from the rich and the poor, even the animals. They put on sackcloths. And a sackcloth is like a burlap sackcloth. It's rough, it's kind of itchy, it's very uncomfortable to wear. Not one drop of food or one bite to eat. Even the king disrobed and put on a sackcloth and sat in the dirt. By doing this fast, showed God that the city meant business and they would turn from their wicked ways and that they would repent. They were hoping that God would change his mind about destroying the city. And God did. God did just that. He changed his mind and did not destroy the city. Jonah's 4, 1, 2, 6, and 7. Jonah is angry at God's compassion. Jonah was furious. He yelled at God and said he knew that God would show them mercy And that is why he ran off to Tarshish. Jonah asked God, since he wasn't going to kill them, could he kill him? He was better off dead, he told God. God asked Jonah, why are you so angry? Jonah left and went into the city of the east, and he sulked. Jonah, he pouted. He pouted the entire time. He hated Nineveh and hated going to the city. God arranged for a broad, leafy tree to spring up. It grew over Jonah to cool him off and get him out of his angry way. Jonah was pleased and enjoyed the shade tree. Life was looking up for Jonah. He was enjoying the tree. But then God sent a worm by dawn of the next day. The worm had bored into the shade tree and withered away. God sent a hot and blistering wind from the east. The sun beat down on Jonah's head, and he started to faint. Jonah prayed to die, and he said he was better off dead. Then God said to Jonah, what right do you have to be angry about a shade tree? Jonah said, plenty of right. It made him angry enough to die. God said, what is this? How is it that you can change your feelings from pleasure to anger overnight about a mere shade tree that you did nothing to get? You neither planted nor watered it. It grew up one night and died the next night. So likewise, why can't I change my mind about Nineveh from anger to pleasure? A big city of more than 120,000 childlike people who don't know right from wrong, to say the least of the innocent animals. Jonah thinks that their preservation was a bad thing. By God allowing the leafy tree to grow one day and die the next, was showing Jonah that God had both grace and mercy and forgiveness for those who are disobedient. And he can change his mind from wrath if they just repent and follow him. God was also showing Jonah that his priorities were in the wrong place. Praise God. This is something that we all need to be careful not to let our own desires or our wants get in the way and blind us of God's mission. Jonah had a second chance. There's that word again, second chance. And was forgiven so he could go to the city of Nineveh to give God's message. Jonah had a chance to show mercy to the people of Nineveh. God is a sovereign God, and his purpose for all creation is to serve him and follow his plan. Our ways are not like God's ways, and our thoughts are not like God's thoughts. Why is it that when we feel like we don't want to do something, that we don't have to go and do it? God has both a plan and a path, and we must follow God's plan and God's path. We must stay in connection with God in order to stay on track with his plan. It's not about us. It's about God. Grace is unmerited favor that God gave to humanity by mercy and sending his son Jesus to die on that rugged cross. He came down 40 and two generations. But on the third day, Pastor, on that third day, he rose. He rose with all power in his hand. Praise God. So thank God for his mercy. Thank God for his grace. Thank God we're able to see another day. Another day means grace and new mercy. Thank God that he shows mercy to all of us. Thank God. Thank God that we are able to see another day to follow God's plan. Praise God. Thank God that he knows all and he sits high and he looks low. Praise God. Second Chronicles 2 and 7 and 14 says, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sin and heal their land. Praise God. Thank God we don't have to worry about that coronavirus. Praise God, because if we belong to God, he is our protection. If we belong to God, he is our stronghold. Thank God, for I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God. Praise God. Which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Praise God. So just in case you was wondering about what's going on in the world today, God's got it all in control. Just in case you was wondering if God sits high and does he look low and does he see everything that's going on, God's got it all in control, so we don't have anything to worry about. We might have to wear a little mask here and there, everywhere, but God still got it in control. Praise God. For God have not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of sound mind and of love. Praise God. Have you made a vow to the Lord today? Because I made a vow to the Lord today. I told God, for God, I live for you, and for God, I'll die for you. Thank you, Jesus. When God gives us a task or a plan, we need to run. Not walk, but run and follow his direction. It is important for us to be obedient to God's voice. Praise God. God is standing at the door today, the door of our mind, and he is knocking if you don't have him. He is knocking. Will you let him in today? He is giving you the choice to live for him and die for him. Will you make that vow to serve him? I hope that you choose to live for God today. As the songwriter writes, I made a vow to the Lord and I won't take it back. And once you make that vow, it's important that you keep that vow. Because if you don't keep that vow, that puts you in a dangerous place with the Lord. Praise God. Like Jonah. Praise God. Praise God. And I just want you to know that I made a vow to the Lord. I made a vow to the Lord. I made a vow to the Lord. Every step of the way, I made. that you go every step, step of the way, 'cause I'm made a vow to the Lord. God bless you. Praise God.
Amen. Amen. Have we made that vow to the Lord? That is the question that we all ought to ask ourselves. And if the answer comes back that we have not, then we ought to get in a hurry and make a vow to the Lord that we will go every step of the way, whatever it is that he asks us to do. We've got to remember that God is a sovereign God. There is no running from his presence. And I thank God that Minister Goodson reminded us today that when God gives us a direction, it is a direction that he means for us to follow. He is a sovereign God, and he tells us what to do. And there is no running from God. There is no running from his presence. There is no running from what it is God has charged us to do. We, as children of God, have a charge to keep, a charge to serve God, first of all, and a charge to serve this present age. And God is holding us accountable. He is holding us responsible for doing what he charges us to do. I thank you, Minister Goodson, for bringing us that word. And as I said, that is a word that is not only appropriate for the youth, but it is appropriate for each of us. Because God has a task for each of us to do, and it is our duty to do our duty. Amen. Amen. That we give God the praise, the honor, and the glory for the message and for the messenger. And as we prepare to go down from this place, let us bow for a moment of closing prayer and benediction. Our Father and our God, it is again that you have been so merciful unto us that you have again allowed us to come into your holy presence with humility in our hearts, with praise and thanksgiving on our lips. Our Father, we thank you again for this day. We thank you for this hour. We thank you for this moment and this second. We thank you for the purpose for which we've come, to share your word with the saved and the unsaved. We thank you for what we have been able to do here today. We thank you for what our eyes have seen, what our ears have heard, and certainly what our hearts have believed. Again, we thank you for the messenger, and we thank you for the message which she brought. And as we go down from this place, we announce your benediction upon your people. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with each of us, now, henceforth, and forevermore. And as we go, we say, amen. Amen.
I heard somebody say this the other day. Listen, if you please. I may